Hello, hi guys. You're watching a Vox ASMR. Today, sorry, I look terrible. I'm doing a little cosplay. Tutorial almost, I guess. It's just a production video where I show you guys how I sort of start off on making a costume. I thought it might be quite fun because it involves me writing and tapping stuff and cutting things. And for a video, I thought it might be quite cool. So it will be kind of like a tester video. You guys might not like it, but I might possibly stream this process. Basically, I am going to be creating Widowmaker's new character skin for a convention that I'm going to in May, and I will just show you a picture of the costume. So this is the outfit that we are planning to make. This is what it looks like. It's very cool. It's very interesting, I think. And I'm excited to make it. So what we're going to be doing today is starting templates for certain parts of the armor. And today my tights turned up, or the purple stockings that she has. She has these purple stockings on, so I ordered those and they just turn up. And they're a very nice color. Sorry for the background noise again. My heating is pretty loud. I also got this gold vinyl, which you heat up and it will stick to the surface you put it on. So it's kind of like if I had a silk dress, which is what I'm doing. Attach shapes of gold to that dress by ironing them onto it with this. So I'm excited to try this because I've seen other cosplayers use vinyl before and I've never actually used it myself, so it's gonna be fun. So the first thing that we do when we make a costume is we have to get the correct measurements for the parts of the outfit. And there are many things that we need the measurements for. On this specific costume we have there's like these little bits on her dress which we will be designing after I've made the actual dress. There's this leg piece on her knee. There's also this gauntlet and then a shoulder arm piece. And then there's the gun, but I will need the gun after the costume is complete. So, what do we need? First of all, paper. You need lots and lots of paper for your templates. I enjoy using A3 paper, not A4, but at the moment all I have is A4 paper. A3 paper is easier for doing templates because most stuff tends to be bigger than an A4 piece of paper. After that, you're gonna need lots of foam sheets. Foam sheets are my best friend for making thinner pieces of armor and adding layers and details to armor pieces. And because the dress has a lot of details on it, I'm gonna be using these foam sheets to create those details. You can pick these up online for quite cheap. I think it's like £6 or so, and they're very good. And that's where we're starting at. At the moment, my foam sheets, my foam mats have not turned up, but I also use foam mats. This is just part of one. But the foam mat is bouncy, like bubbled on one side, and then smooth on the other side. And this is the side that we use for armor. The foam that I'm using is 2 millimeters, and that's what I make all of my armor out of. There's a lot of other foam options available, but this is just what I personally use. Next, we need a tape measure. Can see I've got a lot of pen markings over it where I have used it to line armor and do all sorts of shapes and stuff. So it's very dirty, but it's super useful for a lot of things. When you're measuring yourself, when you're measuring a line for, let's say, a piece of armor, you want to make sure it's long enough, or for a prop, a weapon, you want to make sure your sword is, I don't know, say you're making a sword, you're going to want it to be at least 30 inches long, and so you can just easily measure that out onto whatever material you're working with. And then I have a little ruler too, which is for smaller intricate details and corners and anything that requires a short length, because it's sturdier. If you'd like me to make a video where I just play with cosplay resources and don't talk, let me know. So, for what we are making first today, I need a book to write down measurements. For reference. So this is kind of how it would be if I do a live stream. So this is kind of an example for that, for you guys, to see if you would like it. The first thing that I want to work on is the gauntlet, because if I can get the gauntlet ready before my phone turns up, then want to get an estimate of the shape and size of the gauntlet. So So it goes round quite a lot. It goes around the arm to probably here and here. So there's a very small gap. There's about a two inch gap around the back of my arm. So when we're trying to guess roughly how wide it's gonna be the whole length of my arm minus 2 inches. The whole width, sorry. So, what we do is we take a measurement of the upper of my arm, and that is, I'm gonna say 10 inches, even though it's actually 9, because foam sheets are very big, they're thick. You have to add excess inches to cater for the shape and size. So, I'm gonna say 10 inches. Take away 2, which is 8. So we've got an 8-inch gauntlet going around. In my eyes, that's still going to be too thin. Because if we take a look at our foam piece, when we put that onto this material, this is just scraps, you can see that that is very short. But what we're going to do now that we've got this scrap piece is cut it out. And take a look at how much that goes around our arm. This is the good thing about having scrap material is that you can test out stuff with the scraps. So your actual work becomes a lot more well-made. So, though there probably ain't many triggers in this video, I do hope that it's interesting. So, my scissors. Those ones don't sound nice. These ones do. We're gonna just cut the foam. I need my bigger ones. That is the 8 inches that I decided would be long enough for my arm. Now, test to see how wide that sits around the arm. So, if we put it at the top, that sits just like that. As you can see, it comes around my arm quite a lot. That's gonna be perfect, I would say, actually, because it's not too round. There's still some space at the back, which she has some space on it. But it's gonna have to be a little bit wider than that because there's it doesn't corner the arm so much at the top. So when there's a curve, we have to add extra measurement. So 8 inches will be kind of on the gauntlet. That 8-inch mark will probably sit around here, and then well, around here, and then we'll go a little bit wider, and we won't bend it in so much when we heat it up. And so with that in mind, I'm gonna start drawing out a rough template from what I personally think might work. It's very improvised cosplay when you're creating a template for something. It's a lot of guessing and estimating. And we'll probably need to join up two pieces of paper. But we will see. So, 8, yeah, we'll join two pieces of paper. So, I'm just gonna break two pieces off. Right. So, I broke off two pieces of paper. paper, and I'm going to use some masking tape to join them up. Right, so I've joined up the top and the bottom pieces of the paper now. And this paper, as you can see, is definitely wider than we're going to need it. And it's a lot longer than we're gonna need it, so you know you got a good template. Right. So, the gauntlet in my eyes is kind of, let me go and give you a rough idea of the shape that I'm thinking it is. In my eyes, it is. With layers, so it's actually a basic shape from what I can tell. It's actually, I think it's two pieces on top of each other, possibly. It's very, very difficult to tell, but I might make alterations to the design. But from my ideas, I believe it's kind of like, it's a pretty basic shape. That's not matching up at all. Terrible example, but the base layer, I believe, is something like this shape, and then there's an extra layer on top, which I think goes like, I'm gonna say, kind of, almost like this, and it comes in a little bit, and it goes down, and actually I think the shape of this gauntlet is a little bit different to what I'm exampling you, so I think it actually and then it spirals out with this design. But it's set on an inward gauntlet. The gauntlet doesn't cope out like I thought it did. It goes inwards, which is a shame. But I think this is roughly the kind of sign that it's going on. There's some weird curls on it. It's quite difficult to tell though. I just know that there are some parts that do this kind of thing that I'm drawing up. I will have to get on my game at a later date. Have a look at our gauntlets again to try and get some more photographs, because I don't really actually have that many. So that's almost what is going on. And I'd like to believe that it's pretty similar. Almost. And then there's this big detail going on in the middle. So I'm just going to I'm just gonna really basically lay out this middle piece because I'm not really interested in the middle piece. I'm just layering it for perspective. Right. Okay, so the middle piece isn't important, so I'm just putting lines through it. That's very inaccurate, but it's kind of like thought of like this design. This is the second layer on top, and then this is the third layer. There's also like a fifth and sixth layer, but we'll get to those another point. For now, we just need the basic template. And I said the basic template was going to be 8 inches wide. So we get our measure and we start. I'm going to add an extra inch on the template because it's always better for the design to be too big, and then we can shrink it down and adjust it accordingly as opposed to making a piece that's too small and then we have to throw it away. So I'm going to make it 10 inches, right, 9 inches because I said it was going to be 8 at maximum. So we're going to have it at 9 inches wide, which is probably going to be too big, but we can shrink it down. So wait, I need to turn it this way. And I'm going to use a felt pen for this. Oh no, that's not a felt pen. I don't think I have any black felt. Okay, well, use red then. It up 9 inches. 9 inches is at the top of the design, about 3.5 inches from the top of the gauntlet. So if we cater for that, we'll put two dots either side of those 9 inches, and I would say it goes up about those dots are there, and then the gauntlet comes up to about here, which is going to be about 3 inches. So what's half of 9? Half of 9 is 7.5, right? No, not 7. 4.5, right? So 4.5, yeah? I don't know, I'm not good at maps. It's quite difficult. Yeah, 4.5. So I'm going to put a marking on the page at 4.5, and with my black pen, I'm going to make a straight line down the page so we have a center point at all times to reflect on. This is important on all templates, in my opinion. A lot of people do templates online and they'll do them very more complex than I'm doing. But I'm very wishy-washy and improvise as I go. So, yeah. So we've got, so far we have the line down the middle and the two dots and then the middle point of the page. Next, we want to figure out how high we're going from the middle. So I said 3 inches, roughly. So at the top of the 3 inches, and I said it's quite a concave. It's not a diagonal. It's more like this, not like that. It's like this. So we need to angle it as we're coming up. In fact, it's very curvy. There's about a 2 inches at the top of the gauntlet, which is pretty much running at the same height. So we don't want it like this. We want it like that at the top. So I'm going to do that first, and I'm going to go an inch either side of that design at that same length. And we're just going to run the rest of these details in pen. You'll see, because once I've finished adjusting the lines with my pen, I can go over the correct one in the red felt tip. Okay, so going about the same distance for the first inch, not really making much change to the length, and then we keep on a similar way going all the way down. So we're just gonna angle it I think I like this. That seems fine. Same, I'm left-handed, so I have to move stuff quite a lot, which makes templating a lot more complex. Right, so that's even. It's almost the same. But what I tend to do is I'll do both sides, and then which side I'm more content with, I will split the paper in half and cut it out that side that I like, so that it is an identical gauntlet. So far I'm happier with this side than that side, I think. I think this side runs better. So now we are coming to the side of it, so we need to go back to a side profile, and the side profile doesn't really say this is the edge of the gauntlet. It sort of runs down the arm pretty straight. It doesn't really, it's not like on a really diagonal, it's quite straight. So it's probably like a 30 degrees sort of inward. The second thing we do before we're gonna do the line going down is we need to decide how long the gauntlet is going to be. So on this picture, the gauntlet is actually rather short. Most gauntlets come to like here on a person, like right here, but hers actually come up here, not here. So they're a little bit shorter than most people's gauntlets. So it runs from about here to here, or actually runs to here on her. Apologies, my camera died. So I just recorded this little extra video clip here after I finished the design, which took me about 2 hours to actually draw up from start to finish. So as you can see, I have added color coding. It's not clear in the video, but there's lots of colors. There's also letters, like here I've done J, C, L, K, M, and all these different numbers, which represent each different layer. So all the layers that are the same as each other have been layered with the same color and the same letter, which means when I come to craft these pieces, I can cut out all the different shapes and know which piece goes where. A, which is written everywhere, as you can see, piece of foam. And if you have a look when I turn the thing around in just a moment, you'll see this is what the basic shape of the gauntlet is going to be. I hope